Hey ladies, thank you so much for joining me today. Coach Hannah here. So today we have a really specific topic, a really easy one. So it's gonna be a quick and dirty live. So basically, what I wanna talk today about is why your workout classes are not working. Your workout classes are not equating to weight loss. Hey Lisa, thanks so much for joining. So this is gonna be a really, really simple topic, and I really wanted to touch on this because this is something I have somehow been hearing on repeat over and over and over and over again. Hey Erica, so good to see you. But I've been hearing this from a lot of new clients coming in, and I'm just realizing that it's just a lack of understanding and a lack of expectation that needs to be kind of addressed. So basically, I have women that come to me who have been so compliant and structured and rigid. Hold on, I hear Diego making a funny sound. What is he doing? Good, he's just chewing on one of my chairs. That's great, not a big deal, but he might have to make an appearance in the video. It's just gonna be exciting for all. But basically, I have a lot of women come in who have been doing workout classes religiously, a couple times a week for years, and they've never really gotten the body they wanted. Maybe they lost a little bit of weight if they hadn't come in already. If they started the exercise class really not working out very much, and then they started working out, they got a little bit of weight loss, and then it just kind of stopped. Or maybe they were already kind of active, but their friend was like, hey, let's do this body pump class, or like one of those pound classes, or take to Soul Cycle or whatever. And you were already working out, but you tried that instead, and it's just nothing. You're like, what the? I get there. I go early. I get the best little bench thing, or like, you know, I got my weights, I got my thing, I got my outfit. Like, what is it? I get it. You are working so hard. You're doing nothing wrong. It's just the problem is the workout class. There is nothing wrong with a workout class, and those trainers are wonderful. I don't think I could handle being in front of that many people all at one time with them looking at me. I can handle this because I can actually see you. But those workout trainers are wonderful, but the whole purpose of those classes are to create community and enjoyment and movement of your body. All great things, but without a tailored program specific to you, you can't expect results specific to you in regards to a workout class. So think about it. If you want to look a certain way, if you are tracing a certain physique, and you show up every week to a class that anyone can walk into, you can't really expect individual results from a one-size-fits-all workout program. Yes, you can change the amount of weight you use. Maybe you're lifting more weight than that girl next to you, or you're pumping harder than the girl next to you, or you managed to bust out more push-ups or whatever than the girl next to you. That's totally fine. Hey, what's up, Jordan? But basically, the class is the same. You're just changing the difficulty level a little bit by changing your weight or the amount of reps or whatever. But in reality, you are taking a workout class and expecting very unique individual results, even though anyone under the sun can take that workout class. So that's the first thing you need to kind of get your mind right, is if you want results specifically to you and your body, and you want to look a certain way, you got to train that way and you got to eat that way. It is just one of those things. I hear it all the time. Like, I want to look like one of those bikini girls. And I'm like, well, do you know what they are actually doing? And once you actually hear how hard it is sometimes for those girls to get that look, to step on stage, I don't even coach that way, is they're like, oh, nope, not willing to do that, which is fine. So it's all about setting the expectation. If your goal for going to the class is just moving your body and enjoying it and just being a healthy, active person, hell yeah, go to the class and enjoy the hell out of it. But if your ultimate intention is to change your physique, see weight loss, and get a different body composition, then those workout classes are just not going to fulfill that need for you. Hold on, Diego's now doing something different. Diego, hi buddy, come here. I don't know, this is just great. You guys are just watching a train wreck happen right in front of your eyes, so you're welcome. But anyway, let's go back to the exercise class. So the main reason these exercise classes are not actually giving you the body you want, they're not making you look like that toned, strong physique that you see in other girls that you're like, what does she know that I don't? There's got to be something no one's telling me. It's this. If you want that body, you have to train with intention and get everything out of the training avenue that you're doing, hence weightlifting and cardio. If you are weightlifting, the entire intent behind weightlifting is to challenge and fatigue your muscle tissue, your lean tissue, the tissue that makes you look toned, whatever word you want to use, I don't care. But to get that look, you need to take your muscles to the point of fatigue. You need to lift at your max capacity to challenge the tissue enough so it gets broken down during the training process. Then on the recovery days, it rebuilds, and then you break it down, and then it rebuilds, and then you break it down, and then it rebuilds. That is how weight training works and gets you the muscle that you want. So to lift to your full capacity, your entire focus needs to be on lifting and lifting as much as you can in a safe manner for your form. Lifting heavy does not make you look bulky, I promise. I lift very heavy. If you think I'm bulky, that's totally fine. I don't think I'm bulky. All the girls you see that you probably want to look like, that you see, like fitness people, all the things, are lifting so heavy, it's unbelievable, because they know that's what needs to happen to get the muscle tissue you want. So you have to lift to full capacity. Diego. Hey, stop it. Good grief. Anybody want a puppy? He's not even for sale. You can just have him.
Oh my God.
Anyway, so then lifting needs to be done at full capacity to develop the lean muscle tissue. You have to lift heavy weights. Or if you're using light weights, you need to do a lot of reps to the point where that weight eventually feels very heavy and you're fatigued. Cardio. Cardio's sole purpose is to burn calories. You want to use it strategically and sparingly in a weight loss journey. That's a conversation for another day. But if you think about it, you're trying to get your heart rate up to a certain level and keep it there during cardio because you're trying to burn energy by keeping your heart rate at that higher level. Hey, what's up, Becky? So basically, you want cardio to be bring up the heart rate and keep it up there for the duration that you're doing cardio, and you want weight training to be able to be done to its full capacity so you're lifting the max amount of weight that you can. So, if you go to one of those exercise classes, that is the combo, like the booty, pump, hit, shred, body, whatever. I'm sure their names are super duper fun. Hey, Nancy, thanks so much for joining. Is those classes combine the two together. So if you are combining your weight training and your cardio, again, it can be super fun. So if you're just trying to enjoy yourself, have at it, enjoy the hell out of it. The music's great, whatever. It's a great atmosphere. But if you're really trying to maximize your training, you can't lift to your full capacity in a class like that while you're also comboing cardio. Because if you're tired from the cardio, when you're trying to lift, you can't lift to that full capacity. Hey, what's up, Carlina? Hey, Olivia. Thanks, Elise. So happy to see everyone. But if you are literally doing a little bit of cardio so your heart rate's coming up, so you're getting kind of fatigued, then you do lift, you can't lift to full capacity, not because your muscles can't handle it, but because you're just low on energy from the cardio that you just did. But then when you were just starting to get your heart rate up from the cardio, you stopped the cardio to do the lifting, so then you start lifting and your heart rate is going to come down because you're not doing cardio anymore. Then there's a rest period, then you go back to cardio, and then you do a little more cardio, and then you try and go back to lifting, then you're trying to do a little bit of lifting. So the lifting cannot be done at full capacity if you're already tired from the cardio. Hence, if you're actually doing lifting and cardio in the same workout session, lift first, cardio second. If you have any questions about that, DM me after, because that is a different conversation again. But then you can't lift at full capacity because you're tired from the cardio, but then cardio isn't really done to its full capacity because, excuse me, because then as you start working out and you get your heart rate up, it's like, nah, just kidding, psych, we're gonna lift again. So there's, you're not trying to confuse your body. You're not gonna confuse your body into losing weight. Really? Really? It can't happen. You have to train with intention. So you're not getting all the bang for your buck when you're comboing lifting and cardio at the same time. You can't lift heavy enough because you're already tired and your cardio is in small enough spurts. Diego! Hey, let's stop eating that. Super duper, I love puppies. Ah! Anyway. So you're shortchanging yourself in those exercise classes. You're doing cardio and you're doing weight training, but neither are really done to their max capacity, and they're always gonna leave you with those results that are just unfulfilling. You're like, what gives? I come here all the time. Your time would be better spent lifting with intention and then doing cardio separately, separating the two entities so when you actually do them, you get the maximum benefit of each. The anomaly is if you start an exercise class program and you are a couch potato. You are not a very healthy person. No judgment. That's fine. You're trying to get healthy and that's a super new stimulus. You are going to lose some weight. But for those of you who are already fit, you're already relatively active. You're relatively healthy. You just don't really look how you want. You would feel more comfortable in your skin if maybe you had a little less on your body. That's okay. You are justified to feel how you want in your body. And if losing some weight lends to you feeling better, go after it. It can be a very empowering thing. But then you have to go after it with intention and maybe not do those classes just because they're fun. Sometimes you have to do something that might be a little bit less fun. Oh, thanks, Nancy. So happy you're loving this. But exercise classes are great. They're fun and they're social. So you have to realize, what am I trying to get out of this? If just the process itself is what you're seeking and you just want to enjoy it and have fun and move your body, do the classes. That's so great for you if that's what makes you feel good. But if your ultimate goal is the result of what you're looking for, then you just may need to change your approach from the most fun and bumpy, blasty, music-y, whatever, to something that's a little bit more tailored to your specific needs. So that is really what I wanted to cover today, is why those exercise classes, why your workout classes aren't working. You're doing everything right. You're just taking a little bit of a different approach to get to where you want to go, and it's kind of taking you that way when you really want to go that way. So if you have any questions, ladies, please drop them in. That is really all I have for you right now. Diego is still eating that chair. All right, question. For those people that start with these HIIT classes and lose weight, won't they plateau at a certain point? Yes. And are they stop? And probably if they stop, won't that weight likely come back since it's so heavily cardio? Also, yes. You're paying attention, and I'm just saying, throwing it out there, she's a client, she knows what's up. Way to go, Erica. But yes, so you will get that initial weight loss. Likely, if you're consistent, it will eventually stop losing weight. If you have 5 pounds to lose, then you start the exercise class, you'll probably get those 5 pounds off if you're not exercising at all. That's fine. But if you want to lose a considerable amount of weight, a plateau will hit. And then if you completely stop what you're doing, then likely the weight will come back on if you don't maintain any of the active habits that you've picked up along that journey. So 100% correct. Any other questions, ladies? Let me know. Drop them in now. Otherwise, if you have any questions or you came in a little bit late and you watched the replay, drop them in the comments. Shoot me a DM. You guys know I'm very easy to get a hold of. I'm here to support you in any way you need. Oh, good. Now you stop chewing it. Okay, he's going to make an appearance. Who wants to see Diego? Whee! Say hi, bye. Hello. I just ate Hannah's chair. Nom, 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 nom. But hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Thank you so much for joining, and we'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.